rock like this in a long time.
Get your towels ready, it's about to go down.
So you're probably asking yourself, what in the world is going on? Where is she? What's happening? Yeah, my stomach was saying the same thing.
I'm on a boat. I'm on a boat. Everybody look at me because I'm sailing on a boat.
The reason why I'm on a boat is because I decided to travel from Hong Kong to Macau. Similar place to Hong Kong. It's not part of mainland China, but it's within China. Not many people have heard of Macau or even know what it is, but it's basically like the Las Vegas on this side of the world. A simple hour-long ride on the ferry connects Hong Kong to Macau.
Turns out that I didn't get the proper
Chinese
stamp sticker for my ticket, and they didn't rip the bottom off, so I'm just sitting anywhere on this ferry. But it's okay, because we are going to the same place anyways. I have all my bags, I'm trying to walk on the aisle, so I have a vacant seat, so we can sit in, going like side to side, and all my additional ballots. I got a buff bag, and this book bag, and that bag. I'm just like, I miss bags lately. But it's okay. No need to complain. I made it.
The very first thing I noticed as soon as I stepped off the ferry was how everything is written in Portuguese, Chinese, and then if you're lucky, maybe some English. However, everything was definitely written in Portuguese, but they don't speak Portuguese. They only speak Chinese, no English.
With my luggage. That's how we do it.
How you doing?
He's really wearing my book bag.
Looks great on me. But I like it here, you know?
Did you choose here because it's Portuguese colonial?
No, I don't need it. Nora, what's in front of me?
To have a car here, because I know like in Beijing it's expensive to have a car. I'm in Portugal, Lisbon. Just kidding, I'm in Macau. Oh, it's so beautiful. Which way are we going? I'm following you.
Yeah.
Okay. Walking down the Macau. Oh, look at the facade, that's so pretty. What's the name of it, do you know?
Ruínas de São Paulo.
Ruínas de São Paulo. Wow, I love it.
Ruins of St. Paul.
Ruínas de São Paulo. I want to learn Portuguese so bad.
You
I think it would make me
Portuguese.
Look. It would make me feel so sexy. I'm in a very historical area of Macau right now. Macau is another version of Hong Kong, but it's really big in the sense of gambling. Reputable gambling spots in the world, kind of like Monte Carlo in France. And this is the facade of the church. This was it was destroyed from an earthquake, and this is the only thing that was left standing. And then over here behind me, I'm gonna try to travel up there. That is a fortress where, well, my friend was telling me, because Macau is basically a mixture of Portuguese and Chinese. Isn't that crazy? That's awesome. So that fortress over there, when the Dutch decided to try to enter Macau, so the Chinese and the Portuguese that were living very segregated decided to come together, and they fought the war, and they were able to chase the Dutch out. And the architecture here, it looks very European. I've been to Portugal before, and walking down the central area looks like walking down Lisbon. It's beautiful. Love it.
Welcome to the top of the fortress. Let's go. Get it. center of Macau has made it onto the UNESCO World Heritage List. So definitely check this out if you ever get to make it to Macau. And then go to a night market. Night markets are so popular in Asia. Macau wouldn't be complete without a visit to a casino. My friend and I went to the Sands Casino, where we both learned just how seriously the Chinese take gambling. So serious, we had an old lady yell at us for almost wanting to hit instead of pass when playing blackjack. Thanks for watching, and you can find out more information about where I went, the music used, and other questions you might have in the comment section below.
If I've learned anything on this trip, it's how to not backpack, because I look like I just ran away from home. Leaving Macau, on to Vietnam.